Welcome back to my channel. It is Pluto of Pluto's Muse. How are you? This is going to be your June monthly read for the month of June 2023. I didn't mean to repeat that, but it is what it is. We are going to cover your love life, your career, and your overall energy for the month. If you enjoy this video, please like, comment, share, subscribe, turn on your notification bell, check out my other social medias in the description box below. Everything that you probably are looking for is in the description box below. what else? I'm trying to figure out what else is important. Channel songs are also down below. We will have channel songs for your month, like every other month. But let's see, we're gonna get straight into the reading to see what Virgo needs to know in the month of June 2023. A message from their ancestors. Well, you have great teacher. Learn from spiritual experiences. Some of you guys are Christians in this reading. Some of you will be connecting more with Christianity or your faith in the month of... Why is this not situated? In the month of June. Some of you guys are really going to be learning from some sort of spiritual experience you have this month. Very interesting. I'm also getting to pay attention to the signs. Doves may be significant. Messages for Virgo, June 2023. Messages for Virgo, June 2023. Please, Spirit. You got two that came out. You have spiritual growth. And heavenly signs. Yes, I'm getting that you guys are going to get a lot of signs in the month of June. For some reason, I want to say July. This energy may carry into July, whatever it is I pick up on today. But I am getting June. You are going to be going through some level of spiritual growth. Some of you could be going through ascensions. I'm even hearing some of you guys may get baptized. All right, this is very interesting. The time says 8:55. I'll put that angel number on the screen. Some of you are definitely connecting more to your spiritual beliefs in the month of June, Virgo. You have sexual energy. So your sacral chakra is important during the month of June. And you also have expression. Your throat chakra is significant. Look, what number is this? Oh, I thought it says 6 and 2. I was about to say June 2nd may have been significant for you. Somebody could be born on May 2nd or May 17th. That would be a Taurus. All right, so Virgo, a Taurus may be significant for you in the month of... June. I'm also getting two with this dove. There could be something going on here where people are releasing doves. God forbid, but there could be a funeral. All right. And if not a physical funeral, this could also be visits from a passed over loved one, someone you went to a funeral for. All right. This person could look like this person, or you look like this person, or it's just giving Jesus. Like somebody's connecting with Jesus in the month of June. Somebody could also again have an ancestor who was Christian who is significant here. Your oracle for the month is arrow, focus. So yeah, this month you may be focused on your spirituality. Your sacral chakra and your throat chakra are being highlighted in the month of June as well. So maybe you will be abstaining from sex in the month of June, or you will be communicating boundaries in your sex life. All right. It says arrow. You may even be making some sort of promise. Again, you could be abstinent. It says arrow. Like the many arrows on this card, your mind is flitting. Your mind is flitting in many directions and your thoughts are scattered. However, you are being urged to bring some order into your life and make plans. The only way for you to achieve your dreams is by decluttering all those thoughts well enough to determine what they even are. It's time to become like one arrow in the center of this card that shoots straight to the point. You can achieve this by taking time out to decide what your goal is, planning how you can reach it, working out a schedule to stick by, and then focusing. You will find that you become stronger and more grounded as you go straight to what you really want in life. Focus on positivity and you will make your mark. This is the way to good fortune and blessings for the world around you and ultimately for yourself. The incantation of this card, it says, my mind is like an arrow in flight. It's focused, sharp, so that I might hit the mark and reach my goal to free my mind. To free my dreams and feed my soul. Nice. The other divinatory meanings of this card says, start to prioritize. Make a list of what is important for you in your life. Walk away from anything that takes you away from your main focus. Be straight and to the point. Detox your mind through positive thinking. Practice meditation. All right. So meditation is a huge theme for all the signs this month. If you aren't meditating, what are you doing? This is what you should be doing. This is what you should be focused on. I feel like a lot of you guys are, again, going to be focused on your spiritual growth in the month of June. Or you're focused on someone that's focused on their spiritual growth. I'm also getting to you're setting boundaries with people. Maybe there are people in your life that you feel are trying to distract you from your own growth. Maybe they're tempting you with sex or tempting you with things that you no longer want to entertain. Too many thoughts. You're having too many thoughts. I'm getting you're going to focus your energy on one thing. Let's get into your career energy, Virgo. The clock on the phone says 717, so 717 may be significant to you. I'm also going to try to make this reading speedy, so let's hope it's not too long. Virgo, what is Virgo's energy and career for the month of June 2023? Virgo's career in June 2023. Ooh. That was a strong, King of Pentacles, reverse, upright or reverse, spirit, reverse, all right, so King of Pentacles, reverse, either this is your energy or a masculine around you. If this is your energy, some of you guys are overworking, or your money's off. We'll keep going to see what this is about. Whoa. You have the King of Swords. You could be dealing with a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Ten of Pentacles. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Ace of Pentacles. Some of you will be receiving money from a family member this month. Or there's something going on related to your family, to your legacy. Some of you guys are going to get very serious about your legacy in the month of in the month of June. Why was that so hard for me to say? Also, did I say something about Taurus? Oh yeah, the May. A Taurus could be significant in the month of June for you. Why is this King of Pentacles here in reverse? Oh. King of Pentacles in reverse. Whoa, King of Wands. Some of you guys got a lot of men around you, even if you're a man. Nine of Cups in the reverse under this King of Swords. All right. Somebody is not happy. Now, if this is your energy, you could be feeling dissatisfied with a job situation that you're currently in, or just your money in general. Maybe you're in a job where you're working heavily for the cash or for the monetary gain, but there's not a lot of passion. I feel like in the month of June, you're going to want to put more energy into your passion. A Leo may be significant. I'm also getting two. You need to use your discernment. There could be people that want to work with you in the month of June. Be mindful of who you work with. Why is this Ten of Pentacles here? Yeah. Somebody, either you guys are having conflict at a literal job or you're having conflict within a family situation. Some of you guys are really not happy with your job, or somebody is not happy about you changing your energy in your career. This could even be a coworker or a boss or a family member. Some of you guys are going to start having more fun in the month of June, and I feel like your family may be upset about this. Why is the Ace of Pentacles here? You could be hanging out with soul family. This could be friends, even. I'm also getting two. You could be getting money from a father figure, or there is something going on here. Some of you guys are going through a level up yourself financially. Why is this? Oh my goodness, look, I didn't even see this. Some of you guys are in a relationship, or you will be in a relationship. Also, look at these rainbow hands. Some of you guys are in an LGBTQ relationship. Happy Pride. Happy Pride Month to all my Pride happy followers. I'm getting something here about you being in some sort of relationship. Doesn't have to be LGBTQ, but for someone this is, because all these men are giving me a lot of men. For some of y'all, there is multiple people that may want to be with you romantically in the month of June. And for some reason, this is affecting your finances. Why is this King of Pentacles in reverse? Or you are a feminine with a lot of men around you. Look. Why is this Nine of Cups here in reverse? Somebody's deciding to put their attention on love, possibly, or towards something that they love. Yeah. Some of you guys are going to do some research on what it is you actually love to do, or on something creative. Some of you want to get into journalism or writing. You are a creative writer. You want to own a blog. You want to do music. You want to speak about something. You want to write more. There's something coming up here. Like, the vibe is shifting in your career somehow. This could even be soul family. You have a soul family that's going to support you. They really are going to want whatever it is you put out. Or your family is a huge motivating force behind what it is you choose to pursue. Like, you really want your family to see some level of growth, or your legacy is significant here. Why is the Five of Wands here? But I also get people really want your money. Some of you guys want to move into a relationship, and there's people around you who are like, no, I want you to stay here or focus on this because I need your money. You got the Justice card. Yeah, some of you guys are dealing with like some karmic people. A karmic family member. Why is the Justice card here? Some of you could also be going through a court case around your family, or something related to family, or something related to a job situation, something legal. Stressing you out. Or this Libra is stressing you out. Why are they stressing Virgo out? Why are they stressing Virgo? Ooh, damn. They are stressing you out because this is someone that you've blocked, or this is someone you're setting boundaries with, or this is someone that you feel is deceptive, or this person is viewing you this way. Something's going on here. I feel like some of you guys are trying to protect your peace from this person because they are deceptive. Maybe they're trying to stress you out. They're trying to stress you out. This could be somebody you were in a relationship with. Or again, this is somebody in some sort of family dynamic. This could even be something around a church or a spiritual center. There's issues within this group setting. Or around this job. Somebody at a job could be trying to stress you out. Again, why are they stressing Virgo out? Or someone in your family is? I feel like they want to confuse you. They don't want you to make a new decision, choose a new path. Yeah, they don't want you to follow your heart. They don't want you to pursue what you love. Some of you guys are dealing with a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. They don't want you to put more energy into self-love. As well. I don't like how my camera is situated. Here we go. So, what's Virgo's advice? Well, the Chariot. You're dealing with a Cancer. Move forward. What's Virgo's advice? The Sun in reverse. What's Cancer's advice? Ooh, I said Cancer's advice. I meant Virgo's. Whoa. A Cancer may be significant. What's Virgo's advice in career? Whoa. This almost wanted to come up in reverse, but I'll take it upright. Some of you guys are being told to move forward from a situation that hasn't been making you happy. Either something's going on where somebody is using you for financial gain, or they're blocking you from going towards your happiness, or yeah, they're not paying you what you deserve or something like that. Like, you may have another idea or another thing you want to pursue, but in order for you to pursue it, you might have to leave this job behind or leave this investment behind. And I feel like you're being told you should, whether this is a relationship, a family situation, or a lover or a job. Yeah. Like, they want you to go towards your destiny. They want you to take action even without you fully understanding where you're headed next. Like, learn from spiritual experiences. Take advantage of the signs that you're given. You will be given signs. It may even be a sign how somebody responds to you. Maybe you tell somebody that you want to do something new for yourself, or you want to start a project that you really love, or you have a vision for something, and this person may not support you or try to talk you out of it. And I'm getting, you need to move forward anyway. Especially if your intuition is telling you to do it. All right, so in career, you could be dealing with a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, heavy, Leo, heavy, Cancer, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius again. Libra, heavy. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio is also here. All right, let's get into your love life, Virgo. How does Virgo's love life look in June? You got the Six of Wands. Ooh, getting attention. You're a big deal in June. What does Virgo's love life look like in June? Somebody's born around Christmas time. I'm seeing a Christmas wreath on this card. So you could be dealing with a Capricorn or a Sagittarius, or you have these placements in your chart. You came up in the Sag read. You have Eight of Cups in reverse. Queen of Wands. Ooh, you might be dealing with a Aries, Leo, or Sag. Or this person is significant in your love life in the month of June, or you have these placements. The Knight of Pentacles. Some of you are trying to get attention or go back to someone from the past. Or someone that you've walked away from previously, or that walked away from you. Some of you may also be revisited by an Aries, Leo, or Sag that walked away from you. This person has been slow to approach you, but they're going to come back around, or this is you. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Why is the Six of Wands here for Virgo's love life? I definitely feel like some of you are getting attention, even if not from a specific person. I'm also getting something about gymnastics or the Olympics. You have Nine of Swords for this Six of Wands. Five of Wands. Nine of Cups. I hope you could have saw those cards. Some of you guys are stressed out because of one of two things. If some of you are dealing with a feminine energy, you may be stressed out in the month of June because this person is going to be getting a lot of attention. And I feel like there's going to be a lot of people that want this person's attention. And you really want this person. Like, somebody here could be wish fulfillment to you. Or if you are a feminine, this may be how somebody feels about you. You may be getting a lot of attention in the month of June. You're going to be doing really well for yourself, maybe in your career and in some sort of venture you have. Or you just look really good. You're feeling really good. And I feel like somebody, there's multiple people that want you, but there's going to be somebody that is stressing out because they want to get towards you, but you have other people who want you. I also get too, some of you guys are so emotionally content on your own that the people that want to come towards you may feel like they have no reason to be around you. Like, there's something going on here where it's like you stop competing for love, so people start competing for you or something. Why is that Eight of Cups there? I just saw the Death card. You may be dealing with a Scorpio. You have the Hermit card. Could be a Virgo. Another Virgo, or this is you. Yeah, either somebody's trying to come back to you, or you're trying to go back to somebody that ghosted you. Somebody called judgment on you. Again, I'm getting somebody's a dancer. Somebody could be into ballet or interpretive dance. Why is a judgment card here? Oof. This could have been somebody that played mind games with you, or judgment was called on this situation because it was too much conflict. Too much competition, too much conflict, too much arguing. You and this person could have argued or have argued in the past. I'm also getting too, somebody wanted you to compete for them and you didn't compete. So they've been waiting for you to come back around, or this is you, vice versa. You wanted somebody to compete for you. They didn't compete. Now you want them to come back around, or you're going back. Why is this Queen of Wands here for Virgo, the month of June? Ooh, keep seeing a Queen of Cups. Why is this Queen of Wands here? You could be dealing with a Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Aries, Leo, Sag, Virgo. Queen of Pentacles, Six of Pentacles. There could be a fire sign that wants to work with you in the month of June. Or there's something going on here where you are in a space where you can only give so much. You may be giving to the world creatively. You may be pursuing something in your career. I feel like some of you guys have some of you guys have somebody that wants to come back around to you, but you've changed your mind when it comes to what it is you want. Some of you are in a very single energy, a very confident energy, very sexy, very independent, very emotionally fulfilled on your own. You really don't need anybody else. And there's somebody that wants to make a return that may have played a game with you in the past or played mind games or something like that. Somebody really wanted you to compete. And I feel like you didn't compete. Or if they didn't want you to compete, they just confused you. Like somebody may have been playing a game or just confused you in the past. Maybe they were dealing with drama as well. And they had to call judgment on that themselves. But I feel like you're going to be enjoying yourself in the month of June. You could be going out. You could be dating other people. You could be partying. You could be working in environments where you're around a lot of people. You could be going to festivals. The clock says 919. You could be going to festivals or music events. I feel like you're gonna have a really good June. Look, and you're gonna be taking your time. You're gonna be taking your time when it comes to reconnecting with people, or even when it comes down to being with anybody. To be quite honest, you could be focused on your friends this month, your family. You know why too? Because I feel like you guys are going to be in this spiritual energy. Some of you have also changed your perspective on, like I said, sex. Maybe in the past you were in a more lusty energy, or you were connecting with people that were only there solely for sex. I feel like you guys are changing your mind when it comes to that. Either you're being more selective or you're being more open. Why is that Three of Cups there? Ooh. I'll take it. Another card flipped in my hand too. Justice. Yeah. Some of you guys are getting your karma, or somebody is getting theirs. I'm also getting something too where somebody was slow to move away from a karmic friend group or a group of people around them. Or a third party situation. Somebody was slow to get out of a relationship or to disconnect from karmic people. And this may have caused some level of balance to be restored, where, you know, you may have got put in the spotlight and gotten attention. And then this person is left feeling like they don't get enough attention, or like they aren't, you know, receiving what they need. Or vice versa. Some of you are trying to reconcile with a Libra, but something's going on with this Libra. What I was getting in that reading. Why is this Justice card here? Or why is this Eight of Swords here? Somebody's really stuck in their head. This Eight of Swords is here because somebody wants to move forward towards new things. Yeah, you could be holding your energy back from these people. Or if this is a love interest, again, I feel like somebody's trying to move away from a group of people that they were around previously that they feel like no longer serves them, possibly to reconnect with you. But I don't know what you should do about this. You look pretty happy on your own. Let's see what your advice is. The clock also says 9:22. Look, this came out. I'll keep it. King of Swords. You could be dealing with an air sign. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Whoa. Ten of Wands. What's your advice for Virgo and love? Whoa. Five of Pentacles. Some of you guys are being told to leave this person out. This air sign, this fire sign, this earth sign. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Aries, Leo, Sag, or Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Somebody you're being told to leave out. This could be that friend as well. Yeah, some of you guys are being told to leave out somebody that could have been juggling you or somebody that was confusing you. Someone that made you feel like you weren't enough. Someone that had you emotionally discontent, regretful, disappointed, jaded. You need to close out a cycle of going back and forth with someone from your past. Or with someone that just hasn't contributed to your life how you need them to. Maybe this is somebody that, again, has left you behind and you're trying to figure out whether you want to reconnect. I don't think you should. This could be a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Aries, Leo, Sag, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus, Scorpio, Leo, or Aquarius. The cycle is closed. I'm getting that cycle is closed. Some of you guys are supposed to be focused on yourself. Some of you guys are supposed to be focused on your money. Some of you guys are supposed to be focused on a business idea, a project that you've started, something related to your career. So what energy should Virgo be in the month of June? What energy should Virgo be in the month of June? What energy should Virgo be in or embody in the month of June in love? What should they embody? Oh, too many cards, but we'll take them. Queen of Pentacles, period. Whether you're masculine or feminine, you need to be about your bag. You need to know that you are wifey, hubby. You need to wait for what you deserve. You need to know your worth. Yeah, because when you know your worth, then you allow the universe to take control. And then you'll be able to look forward and make plans for what you want that will ultimately bring in what it is you need. I'm also getting too, there's going to be communication that comes in. If you stay in this energy of focusing on yourself, setting boundaries, defining what you want, there will be movement forward in your love life. Or there will be communication that you receive. You may even be in an energy where, again, you're waiting for communication from this person or from someone in particular. I'm getting that you'll receive it if you stand in your power. You could be dealing with a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Aries, Leo, or Sag, Taurus, Scorpio, Leo, Aquarius, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Libra specifically, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius specifically. Sagittarius, Aries, Leo, Sag, another Virgo. All right, and that's it in that energy. Let's do your overall energy for the month, and then we'll pull some oracles to close out your read. Overall energy for, oh snap. This keeps wanting to fall. Some of you have a Mars in Leo. Some of you are dealing with someone who has a Mars in Leo. Some of you are about to get a lot of attention for something, or you are currently getting a lot of attention, and your guides are saying, keep your eyes on the prize, Virgo. What's Virgo's overall energy for the month of June? 2023. I felt a card pop, but maybe not. Six of Swords, King of Cups. You could be dealing with a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. You have these placements in your chart. I'm getting it's time for you to move towards where your emotions are leading you. Towards what your inner child wants. Some of you guys are being asked to connect with someone from, or you will be, not even being asked to do this, but some of you guys are going to be either just connecting with your own emotions or possibly even thinking about a parental figure or someone from your past. Could be your father, could be your mother, could be an uncle, grandparent, grandfather. This person could be sending you messages during the month of June. For some of you, this person loved dogs. No, that's random. Or this person had a dog. Or you love dogs. Maybe you need to think about getting a pet. Some of you would benefit from having a pet. Why is the Six of Swords here for Virgo in the month of... Six of Swords. Sun in reverse. You keep getting that sun in reverse. Some of you guys are depressed or have been depressed. I know I brought that up in that last read. Either you're depressed or you're dealing with someone like this. You could be dealing with a sad Leo. Sad Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Yeah. And you're being told to figure out whether you want to continue pouring into this investment or, you know, they want you to look over what this investment has been to you, how you've operated in it previously, how it has affected all other areas of your life. What's this Four of Pentacles here? Yeah. How this may be teaching you to hold back your energy from people, whether it's sexual energy or creative energy. How this person may have made you feel like you couldn't be as creative as you wanted to be or as authentic. The Judgment card. Some of you guys are also going to decide to pursue something that you love. And this is a skill from your past, a passion from your past. It's going to be something that takes you out of a period of feeling depressed. You're going to revisit an old passion. The clock says 9:29. I'll put that angel number on the screen. What's Virgo's overall advice with this energy? Ten of Cups. Beautiful. Your family is significant here. Your emotional fulfillment is significant here. Temperance. Yeah, here we go. Sag. Some of you guys are dealing with a Sag. Or some of you guys are waiting to... Look at this. What's this? The Lovers. Wow. Some of you guys are definitely deciding to wait to have sex until marriage. That's not for everybody, but some of you guys are definitely doing that. Because you're going to realize that you've been playing out some sort of pattern with people that may stem from your childhood or your upbringing. Yeah, I feel like some of you guys are going to decide to love yourself and wait for the commitment you want. Wait for the type of partner that makes you feel like things are reciprocal. Some of you could be choosing to go towards a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Sagittarius, or Gemini. What's more advice for Virgo in love? Or not in love, Lord, in life. There's something that's going to have to end, though. Maybe an old relationship or an old way of living. Some of you guys may have been, like, partying a lot or looking for connections in the wrong places. You've been connecting with people in environments or at events that weren't really meant to be, you know, considered a dating pool, possibly. Yeah, like, you're trying to be around people who... level you up, or who you feel leveled up around, or who you can grow with. You may be dealing with an Aries, or you are going to go towards an Aries, or some of you guys are going to start some sort of business venture. You may stop hanging out with certain people or end a relationship to focus on your career, or end a connection where you were a third party. Yeah. Because your advice is to focus on what you love or focus on yourself. The more you focus on what you love, the more likely you'll attract the things you love, the people that will love you, things like that. All right, let's get into your oracles to close out the read. Yeah, so keep your eye on the prize. Keep your eyes focused on what it is you want, the type of people you want, and maintain that standard. Don't falter on your standard. Don't be easily swayed by people. What's self-care for Virgo? Whoa, you see how that popped out? What'd you get, Virgo? The number two may be significant. You could be dealing with a Aquarius or a Pisces, or February is significant. Some of you guys are born on September 2nd. Alone time. Some of you need to go to a beach or a body of water. Even with this at the bottom of the deck, with ground yourself. 25 or 7. You could be dealing with a Cancer or a Leo. Some of you guys are definitely being told to spend time alone, meditating, relaxing, contemplating your next move. You need to become one with the earth. Definitely need more time with the earth. Really getting that vibe heavy. This is going to benefit you to ground yourself. And I really get you need to ground yourself because your guides are sending you spiritual signs or divinely guided messages. And if you are too much in your head or too focused on what could go wrong, or you have anxiety, you may really miss out on what it is you're meant to learn or take away from whatever it is that's taking place. So definitely make an effort to ground yourself. Keep yourself at peace in the month of June. Virgo. Ooh. Your cards are popping, Virgo. You have denial. Can you see that? Denial. It says, I acknowledge my fear, but I replace it with the insight of awareness. Yes. So in the month of June, there may be a part of you that really is going to psych yourself out, or, even play victim mentality, or something's going on here where it's like you may have a habit of creating scenarios that aren't actually real. They may even be based around other people's opinions and not your own self-awareness. I am getting that in the month of June, you're going to make an effort to stop denying the facts or your truth because of, you know, your own insecurities or fears or other people's opinions. You also have to surrender. It says, I can release my need to control. Yes, you guys are going to let go of control in the month of June. You need to, at least. I'm getting that there's a strong message here around you kind of just going with the flow. Alone time, going with the flow, being alone, being willing to allow your love life to play out how it needs to, being willing to keep yourself aligned with what you want, and don't worry about how other people are responding. Don't worry about the conflict around your family. Don't worry about the conflict around a friend group even. I feel like it's your time to just kind of trust in the divine. You also have too, doubt. I release the need to know all the answers. Yes, I'm also getting a message here around the fact that with these control issues or these things that you try to control, normally, I am getting that a lot of this comes from a space of you not fully believing or having faith in what's to come. But your guides are letting you know you don't need to know what's coming for you to keep pursuing your dreams. You don't need to know that you're going to, you know, who you're going to end up with for you to maintain your standard. You get what I'm saying? If you want something, stay in the energy of aligning with it and you'll get it. But you don't need to know the details, because a lot of you would ruin these things if you fully knew what the details were, whether somebody was meant for you, whether somebody was going to come back around, whether you needed to speak to somebody, what have you. I'm getting a lot of this stuff you have no idea about because you aren't meant to control it. Even if there's people who have disappeared and now you're in a period of isolation and you're like, oh my God, like, how do they feel? What are they doing? Whatever it is. I would almost tell you, like, you would benefit from only focusing on yourself right now. You know, you don't really need to put too much energy into what other people are doing or where other people are moving. You need to just find some level of inner peace within yourself. All right, let's get you a love oracle as well. Virgo in the month of June. Can I get a love oracle? Wow, this came out so quickly. Act as if your partner is here. Whether you have someone in your life or not, act as if they are with you so you will always consider them. Some of you guys are definitely dealing with a Scorpio, or you have a Scorpio placement. Somebody could also be born on the 10th or in October. This could be a Libra or a Scorpio. Yes. Some of you guys are being told to act as if you are already aligned with your partner or who you want to be with. You also have at the bottom of the deck, take a chance on love. When we love, our lives are changed forever. beautiful. All right. It says, act as if your partner is here. Whether you have someone in your life or not, act as if they are with you so you can always consider them. If your actions and thoughts take someone else's feelings into account, you will be more aligned with a true relationship. If your partner is not with you yet, generate the feeling that you are already sharing your life with your special someone. This will change the way you feel and can alter your attitude and your potential to attract them into your life. Revel in the thought that you are in a faithful relationship. When you create a vacuum by affirming your desire as if you have it, the universe will bring it to you more quickly. You draw into your life the things that are in harmony with your beliefs. Believe and trust that love is coming your way. See your energy as a love-attracting magnet. Live as if you are in your desired relationship and appreciate the phase prior to the arrival of love. Yes, a lot of you guys are being told to act as if you're in the relationship you want so that you can attract the person that you want. Because a lot of you guys are not currently with the person you want to be with, or you're single. You're single, you're celibate or abstinent, you are leaving a relationship behind, or you have left something behind, you're disconnected from your partner somehow, and now you're trying to figure out how to align with someone that you feel is more in alignment with you, your authentic version of you, the new evolved version of you. A lot of you guys have evolved, and this is why you want someone new. This is very good. You also have two. This is 23. Some of you guys are also born on the 5th, or somebody is born on the 5th. This could be a Taurus or a Aries you're dealing with. But this also says, take a chance on love. When we love, our lives are changed forever. So many rewards will come to you when you love openly. Your care, affection, and appreciation will help others and create more love for you. Let your fear go and give the love you are longing to receive. You will find that it is one and the same. Allow love and relationships to evolve in your life. Life progresses and grows naturally. Be your authentic self. Pay attention to what your heart is saying to you. There is a wonderful opportunity coming your way. So I also feel like too, yeah, there's definitely new love coming in, or there's a love opportunity that's about to align with you. And your guides are saying, stay optimistic, be open to love. If it isn't the person you anticipated, don't be upset about that. Be excited, because it may be even a better option for you. A lot of times when you let go as well, the universe will send you exactly what it is you need rather than what it is you thought you wanted. And I feel like if you act as if your partner's already there and you're open when somebody arrives, you'll definitely end up with a partner that is worthy of your time, your commitment, your effort. They'll understand what it is that you want. And if you're dealing with people that are against your way of living, or even like I said, some of you guys are like, I'm abstinent, or I'm going to focus on myself, I'm not going to engage in certain things while I'm in a relationship. If you're with the right person, this person will honor what it is that you're asking for. They're not going to try to manipulate you or make you feel bad for what you said you wanted. They're going to honor that because they respect you. So, you know, maintain your dignity, your integrity in these situations, your standards, your values, your morals. These are important. Continue learning from these spiritual experiences and retain that wisdom you gained in those experiences. These are the things that are going to help you build the proper standards anyway. Your affirmation to go, you have, true healing occurs when I give myself permission to feel whatever feelings live below the triggers. Yes, some of you guys may be feeling triggered in the month of June, and your guides are letting you know, feel the feels. Don't ignore a trigger. Don't ignore your feelings. Under every trigger is some solution towards a fear. You releasing that fear or resolving that issue. Don't be afraid to resolve them. You also have two under the deck. It says, in every moment, the universe is conspiring to bring me toward right-minded thinking and the energy of love. Yes, I also get a vibe here too, where you need to understand that the universe is always going to be right. regardless of what they choose to do, if they separate you from someone, if they cause some sort of rift in a relationship, if they delay some sort of opportunity, your guides are letting you know that just because these things are taking place doesn't mean that it isn't going exactly how it's supposed to. So you need to, you know, start believing in the fact that everything is happening for a higher purpose, a better reason, something that's going to benefit you in the end. And that may help you ease your mind when it comes to what is currently going on or what's to come. So that is all that I have for the month of June 2023, Virgo. Thank you so much for being on my channel. Thank you so much for liking, commenting, subscribing, returning to my channel, leaving any nice comments. Some of you guys comment and I love that. Following me on other social media platforms. If you'd like to do that, you can check out the description. That'll have all my information down there. If you need to book a personal session, my information is down there as well, along with the channel songs for your month. So that is all that I have. I hope you have a wonderful Gemini season. That's your opposite sign season. Or no, that's not your opposite sign season. Somebody in here could be a Sag watching. But if not your opposite sign, it's your sister almost. Like, it's not really your opposite, it's your sister, because Gemini is also ruled by Mercury anyway. Because I'm talking too much. It's too much now at the end of the read. But I appreciate you. And I hope you have a wonderful day, week, month, year. All right. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye, Virgo.